Hey, I think I might have the wrong address. I'm looking for Mr. Herbert's house.
No, you're at the right house. I'm his grandniece, Sandy.
Wow, my name is Chris, too.
Oh, hey there, Chris. Happy Valentine's Day. Hope Cupid brings you a saggy old bag of treats.
Hey, Mr. Herbert. I'm just here to collect for the newspaper.
Here you go. Oh, hang on now, Chris. Your fly's up again.
Thanks, Mr. Herbert.
He's so hot. I'd love to talk to him, but I just don't know what I would say.
Oh, I know all the things to say. Maybe I can help you out.
You'd do that for me?
Sure. Right after my favorite show.
Coming up next, to catch a predator who's proud of being a predator.
Good evening, sir. I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline. Do you know the boy you were coming here to meet tonight is only 13 years old?
No, I drove 900 miles for a 14-year-old.
So, what seems to be the trouble?
Dr. Hartman, something's wrong with me. Everyone's treating me like I'm a broad. I don't know what's going on.
I recognize that hysterical tone of voice. Sounds like someone's having their monthly. All right, sweetie, let me just spit on my hand and we'll get started.
Yeah, get away from me, you creep! My God! There was nothing wrong with my mirror. Everyone sees me as a woman. Oh, no. This is the universe giving me what I deserve for being such a pig all the time. From now on, I'm going to do things differently. Men are jerks. Let's swear off of them and find comfort in each other. Come here, you guys.
Hmm.
Yeah. So what's with you? No Valentine's Day plans?
No. I've had it with Valentine's Day. I'm sick of all of it.
Okay, I'm putting on my friend hat. What's the matter? Let me in.
I don't know. It's just, how come it's so hard to meet the right woman? I think maybe it's just time for me to give up.
Come on, Brian, you can't give up. Everything could change in a moment. That's what happened with the Kennedy assassination.
I'm sorry, gentlemen. Despite our best efforts, the Texas School Book Depository Awareness Council has failed in its mission to generate public awareness of the Texas School Book Depository. So at the end of the day, we'll be shutting down operations and laying everyone off.
Sir, I think you're going to want to see this!
Let's fall in love. Why shouldn't we fall in love? Our hearts are made of it. Let's take a chance. Why be afraid of it? Let's close our eyes and make our own paradise. Little we know of it, still we can try to make a go of it. Let's fall in love.
Oh, Brian, there you are. Look, I've been thinking about your situation with women, and I believe I've come up with a way to get to the source of the problem. Follow me.
What's going on? Oh, my God. Stewie, what the hell? These are all my ex-girlfriends.
Well, I thought they could provide some insights that might improve your love life. Ladies, as you may have guessed, you are here because you have all dated this great guy. Yet somehow things didn't work out. My objective is to figure out why.
I don't know. The word self-absorbed comes to mind.
And pretentious.
Definitely pretentious.
And he's got a big ego.
Okay, we seem to have a theme going here.
Oh, come on. You're all just mad because I didn't want to be with you. I think Brian's a wonderful man. He's just having a difficult time coming to terms with his own sexuality.
Shut up, Ida. She's my favorite.
He's insecure.
And a blowhard.
And he's got a tiny penis.
Yeah, that was pretty clear by the survey. Okay, now who wants more wine?
This is great. We should do this every Saturday. No, no, we're not going to do this every Saturday.
What's wrong? We're just being honest.
Oh, you want honest? You're an old bag. You're blind. Your vomit tastes weird. You don't even know why you're here. You chose to be on the hills. You still have bits of penis left, and you can never get wet. And you, you're more of a woman than anyone else in this room.
Get him!
Oh, honey, I'm so excited to finally meet your girlfriend.
Here she comes now.
Yoo-hoo, baby!
Oh, no!
We now return to Tom and Jerry, the final episode.
So that's it?
That's it.
This is so much easier. I don't know why I didn't do this years ago.
What do you want me to do with the body?
I don't care. Throw it in the garbage.
Do you want any of his oversized mallets?
I will take a mallet.
Yeah, I gotta take this.
Who's calling?
My ex-girlfriend. She calls me drunk every Valentine's Day. Hey, Samantha. Yeah, I'm sorry. I still love Lois. Oh, come on. You would have been a great mom. She had cervical cancer 5 years ago. She's basically a boob on a leg at this point. Well, that's something. You're in a book club? Those are tough to get into. What? Well, I didn't even know the Fine Young Cannibals were still together. 8-city tour. What, I don't know if I can make 8, but I can certainly do 6. What about Lois? She's totally out of the picture. We've done everything but sign the papers. Samantha, I will see you in Binghamton. And now I want you to go and take a picture of yourself, because it will be your last day alone. Jeez, what's not clear about get lost? By the way, my attendance at home is going to be spotty over the next few weeks.
And, well, prize pumpkin from the county fair. That's why I'm naming you my chief of police.
Mayor West, there's something you need to see.
My God, my wife is seeing another mayor.
I'm sorry, sir.
Don't be, because I'm going to win her back. I trust you'll take care of things here in my absence. Officer down!
I hereby declare this public park and future homosexual meeting spot open.
Unhand that woman, you bastard!
Adam!
Well, well, well. If it isn't Mayor Guns for Toys West.
The chair recognizes your face!
On guard!
Is the park open?
Not yet.
You call that kissing a baby? That's how you kiss a baby. I hereby declare this Stabby Eye Day.
Oh, Adam, I'm so sorry.
Carol, I love you, and I can't live without you. Please, never let this happen again.
I won't, Adam. You're the only mayor for me.
Hey, Carol. I almost didn't recognize you without my special sauce all over your face.
Is somebody out there?
Chris, it's me, Uncle Herbert's granny, Sandy.
Oh, hi, Sandy. What's up?
What do I say?
You say, Chris, I wanted to come see you because, well...
Chris, I wanted to come see you because, well, I'm kind of a lonely old man.
Really?
Now, I know I'm not much to look at, and ever since I got banned from the arcade, I don't know what I'm doing. But if you're up for it, I'd like to spend some time with you.
Okay, sure, Sandy. I'll come right down.
Thanks, Uncle Herbert. I don't know how I could ever repay you.
Well, there is one thing. Also, if I gave you a sandwich, do you think you could get Chris to fart on it?
Well, guess I better be going. I gotta get this heart to Madonna.
Oh my God! Madonna needs a heart transplant?
No, she just doesn't want other people to have them for some reason. But before I go, here.
For me? My kidney!
I wanted you to have it.
Oh, Toby, I love it! Thank you! Oh, this has been the best Valentine's Day ever.
Oh, Peter, it was fun spending the day in bed with you.
It sure was, Lois. Happy Valentine's Day. Hey, Lois, remember our wedding?
Yeah, I sure do.
Remember the dance?
Of course I do, Peter.
Who was that half-Persian chick who was dancing with your cousin?
I think her name was Flora.
Yeah. Okay, all right, I'm ready.
What?
Shut up for 10 minutes and pretend we're in the back behind the speakers.